And when I looked up, Father Giuseppe was, oh, I would say, 2 feet off the floor.
Thank you, Brother Tomas.
Brother Leo?
I saw exactly the same thing. Except that in my opinion, Father Giuseppe rose much higher. At least 5 feet.
Thank you, Brother Leo.
Brother Alfredo.
He levitated exactly 19 inches, no more and no less. Because when I heard that the Vicar General was coming from Naples to investigate, I took the trouble to measure it.
Thank you, Brother Alfredo.
Brother Rolando.
I assisted at Father Giuseppe's mass. I knelt directly behind him. There can be no denying what I saw. He flew to the very top of the altar, at least 15 feet.
Thank you, Brother Orlando.
Brother Carlo.
Thank you, Brother. I think we have heard enough from the brothers. If we wait long enough, I'm sure we'll hear that Father Giuseppe has entered into heaven. Brothers, this is not a laughing matter. In fact, it's more serious than I imagined.
But that is why we asked you here, Your Excellency.
Before we bother the Holy Father with our parochial problems, I suggest we try to clean up the matter ourselves.
Exactly.
Father Giuseppe. Father Giuseppe.
Giuseppe.
Father Giuseppe, how was your health as a boy?
Health?
Were you often sick?
Yes. There's a great deal of malaria down here in Calabria and Apulia. Were you ever afflicted with it? Yes. Half the people of Cupertino had it.
Then you should know something about the ravages of the disease. They say it often affects the reason. Is it that so?
Ah, yes. A boy in my class, Franco, he had it. But he's dead now.
But it didn't affect you.
We requested these records from the parish in Cupertino. You weren't a very good student, were you?
No.
Without intending any cruelty, Father Giuseppe, they would indicate you were a very bad student. Why were you so backward?
Does your mind sometimes wander?
Yes.
Doesn't this condition worry you? Haven't you ever seen a doctor about it?
No.
Think back, Father Giuseppe. Do you remember sustaining a serious injury? Did you ever fall and hurt yourself?
Oh, yes. Yes.
Did you ever fall on your head?
Oh, yes, many times.
Aridity sometimes shapes our character, Father Giuseppe. Was your mother ever sick, seriously sick, so that her judgment was impaired?
My mother was never sick a day in her life. She's strong in mind and body.
Shh. Your father.
He was a good man.
Wouldn't you say he drank to excess?
Isn't it possible that it affected his mind?
My father was a wonderful man. He wanted to know about things, to understand. He studied poetry, music. He understood dogs.
This strange power of yours, how long have you had it?
A year.
Does it frighten you?
No.
But do you think the Blessed Mother is responsible for these levitations?
Yes.
Can other things cause you to levitate?
Other things?
Holy things.
Yeah, holy things.
What holy things?
The Holy Mass.
Oh, yes, yes, we know about that. What else?
Can you exercise this power at will? There are so many holy men here. You should be able to fly to Rome. Could you levitate up to there if we asked you? Please, try. Thank you, Father Giuseppe. I'm sure that this phenomenon is a temporary thing and will pass away. Be that as it may, there can be no doubt that here we have a case of divine intervention.
No. I'm sorry, but I must disagree with my distinguished brothers. I mean no disobedience, Your Excellency. And I speak with no personal malice. My feelings in this matter go much deeper than that. This man has deceived you.
Father Raspi.
That's a grave charge.
I do not make it lightly, Your Excellency. This man makes a mockery of the priesthood. 19 inches. 2 feet. 3 feet. 5 feet. And finally, 15 feet. Now, clearly, someone is wrong. Or all of them. Why is there such conflicting testimony? Why is there such wide disagreement?
There may be disagreement on how high he flew. But there is no doubt that everyone saw him fly.
Ah, but did they? Did they? Do they imagine they saw Father Giuseppe levitate?
What do you mean?
They were all bewitched by this man. All bewitched.
No.
He couldn't have bewitched us. He had his back to us.
I repeat, bewitched. The same as the Indian rope trick. Hundreds, oh, even thousands, duped into seeing a man climb a rope suspended in midair. A trick. A faker's art. The devil's genius. Even his ordination was a lie. And was obtained not through grace, but through the intervention of the devil.
Father Raspi!
I charge that Lucifer himself is working through this young man.
What are you suggesting?
Possession.
No.
Diabolic possession.
Father Giuseppe possessed by the devil. You cannot be serious.
Possession is a serious matter, Your Excellency. I do not take it lightly. I understand your feelings about keeping this in the family. But it is my considered judgment that this sorcery is not a parochial matter. I believe it should be reported to the inquisitorial court in Rome.
But a scandal.
There must be some other way.
There is another way, there is. The prescription of the church in matters of possession is very clear. Exorcism.
Oh, come now, Father Raspi. We are not inquisitors. Look at him. Do you really believe there is a devil lurking inside that humble man?
There was once a Lucifer in heaven.
Must we go through with this, Your Excellency?
It's either that or Rome. Before we proceed, we must get his permission. Father Giuseppe.
With your indulgence, Your Excellency, we'll get his permission later, when he's with us again.
Very well, Father Raspi. Purge the devil out of him and clear this matter up once and for all.
From your wrath,
deliver us, O Lord.
From sudden and unprovided death,
deliver us, O Lord.
From the snares of the devil,
deliver us, O Lord.
From anger, from hate, and all evil intentions,
deliver us, O Lord.
From the lightning and the tempest,
deliver us, O Lord.
From perpetual death,
deliver us, O Lord.
The mystery of your holy incarnation, deliver us, O Lord. For your coming, deliver us, O Lord. For your nativity,
deliver us, O Lord.
For your baptism and holy fasting,
deliver us, O Lord.
For your cross and passion,
deliver us, O Lord.
For your death and burial,
deliver us, O Lord.
For your holy resurrection,
deliver us, O Lord.
For your admirable ascension,
deliver us, O Lord.
For the coming of the Holy Spirit, the Paraclete,
deliver us, O Lord.
In the day of judgment,
deliver us, O Lord.
In nomine Patris, et Filii, et Spiritus Sancti. Amen. You will please kneel down. It is the devil who gives you wings. The chains will prevent you from flying. Reminiscaris domine delicta nostra vel parentum nostrorum, neque vindictam sumas de peccatis nostris. Pater noster, qui es in cielo. Et ne nos inducas in tentationem. Precipio tibi, qui cumque es, spiritus immunde, et omnibus socis tuis undei famulum obsidentibus, ut per mysteria incarnationis, passionis, resurrectionis, et ascensionis Domine nostri Iesu Christi, per missionem Spiritus Sancti, et per adventum eiusdem Domini nostri aiudicium. Dicas mi nomen tuum.
Father Giuseppe. Father Giuseppe, what are they doing to you?
It's for my own good little brother, Father. has been driving out the devil.
The devil, you? Oh, no. You're a saint. He's a saint.
Take this blasphemous fool out of here.
Oh, no. No, a moment. The Madonna. The Madonna. It's Father Giuseppe's.
Take him out.
Ecce crucem domine, fugite partes adverse.
Vici leo et primo iura, radic David.
Domini exaudi orationem meam.
Clamor meo sedeve.
Dominus vobiscum.
Et cum spiritu tuo.
Oremus. Adiuro te, serpens antique, per judicem divorum et mortuorum, per factorem tuum, per factorem mundi, per eum, qui avet potestatem mitere te in Gehenam. Ut ab hoc famulo Dei, impera tibi Deus. Impera tibi Maiestas Christi. Impera tibi Deus Pater. Impera tibi Deus Filius. Exi ergo transgressor. Exi seductor, plene omni dolo, et fallacia, virtutis inimice, innocentium persecutor, da locum dirissime, da locum impiissime, oremus.
Oramus te, Deus omnipotens. Ut spiritus iniquitatis amplius non aveat potestatem in hoc famulo tuo, Iosepho. Sed ut fugiat et non revertatur in unitate spiritus sancti Deus per omnia saecula saeculorum.
Amen.
As of this moment, you are free. You're no longer possessed by the devil. And now, let us leave Father Giuseppe alone with his penance.
Father Aspi, the chains.
No, Father Leo. The chains will remain until morning.